Thank you so much, Melissa and Dan and the team for leading us in worship today. God's flight. On the ground sits a bird that's too afraid to fly. Beautiful wings could make it so, but the pain of the past, failure is its lonesome cry. Go to Satan to the bird, trust and have faith in me, for I will carry you in your flight. The miracle of life is waiting for you to see. The bird said to God, but I cannot fly. I'm weak. I will fall and feel pain. It's happened before when I tried to fly. I'm afraid of being hurt again. His voice soft and reassuring, God said to the bird, I created you and I will protect you. Your lonesome cry I have heard. Have faith in me, that's all you need to do. So stand up, bird, and spread your wings. The wings I lovingly created to let you fly. If you fall, I will pick you up and lift you back into the sky. With trembling legs and unsured wings, the bird finally looked to the sky. It took a deep breath and took the chance. The bird began to fly. Thank you, God, for believing in me. Thank you for giving me wings. Thank you for giving me wings. Thank you for protecting, for your protecting hands. Your glory I will now sing. God smiled unto the bird in its majestic flight. Little bird, I will always be with you, and I will protect you with all my might. You may stumble and fall. That doesn't mean that I don't care. I will watch over you in case you need help. And then I will be right there. The little bird, once so scared, learned to soar to new beginnings and new heights. The occasion of fall no longer scared the bird, choosing to have faith in God's flight. That is a poem written by Heather Flood. My host family, recently we watched a movie, and in this movie there was a man who was in prison for quite a long time, and while he was in prison, for a long time he was tortured and a lot of injustice done in this place. And finally, he gets the opportunity to be released out of prison. And when this guy is released out of prison, he goes out, and the habits maybe that took him to prison and even those that he gained or got from prison follow along with him even outside prison. And he goes into a church as he tried to find somewhere to sleep. Finally, a priest walks up to him and says, hey, do you want to come in? We like people like you. So he gets in, and the habits keep happening within him. And he steals the silver and steals a few things, and he's running away. The police catch him and bring him back. When the police brings him back to the priest and says, yeah, he is with all your silver, the priest says, oh, and here's something that you left behind. Please take with you. And the guy is marveled, and he's surprised that he's actually loved and accepted. He always expected to be taken back to prison, but then he's given mercy and forgiveness. And this guy later succeeds in life, later because of this encounter with grace and love and mercy and forgiveness, he begins to live a different life. He begins to soar on the wings like a bird, and knowing that the mighty God is there to protect him. But what very much interests me is towards the end of this movie that this man begins to remember, even in the process of soaring, he keeps on remembering that he's supposed to be in prison. He keeps on remembering that he ran away from reporting to his parole officer. And this bothers him so much that he doesn't successfully fly. And later, at the end of the movie, it breaks my heart that actually this guy runs away from all the things that God had given him, and he goes back and chooses to moan and cry and weep day and night until he dies. Before we define success, I think it's important for us to know. Today we're talking about how do you define success? Many people define success differently. I love asking so much, and so I took time and wrote it on my wall and said, so what do you think success is all about? And just seeing the different things that people say, you know, when you accomplish that, when you do that and that, when you achieve all your dreams, and that's how everybody defines success. One person wrote something very interesting and said, we begin to live when we die. And he was defining success as that. And so I thought before even we define success, it's important to know that for one to succeed, there's need for death. For you to be able to bear fruit, for me to be able to bear fruit, I need to die. Let's look back to the story of this guy with even the poem when God said that I'm there to make you fly even to your highest heights. We remember the story. The guy is flying, but then there are things about him that haven't died. Thank God for Moody Bible Institute. Thank you so much for the support that you've given us to be able to go to Moody. And both of us did spiritual formation and discipleship, and many people that actually went to Moody, the highest percentage have done spiritual formation and discipleship, and we've been trained to die. There's a lot of baggage. There are a lot of traumatic events that have happened in my life, in our lives, that if we're not careful to die, we may not be able to fly. We may try to fly, but we may fall. And many people that have not allowed themselves to die have actually fallen. I know that we come out here and we want to fly and we want to achieve our dreams, but one thing that God has been teaching me is that I've got to die in order to follow him. In order to bear fruit, in order to succeed, I have to die. Another person defines success as obedience to God. In order for me to be able to obey God, in order for me to be able to follow God, I have to die. In order for me to say, yes, Lord, I will follow you. I'm very much passionate about justice. I'm very much passionate about people that are going through what I went through, the pain that I suffered, the traumatic events, the rap, the lack of food, the lack of shoes, trying to find my voice in a corrupt society, in a society that tells us everybody in leadership is against you. Everybody in leadership tries to pull you down, and that's the society we live in. And here I am. God has picked me out of there and brought me to a different environment. But even in my different environment, these things from the past keep showing up. And if I don't deal with those things, I'm not going to be able to fly and I'm not going to be able to succeed. And that has been my process of 3 years in Moody, 3 years in America, God pointing out those areas that I must die to. I must die to the desire, to the of accomplishments, of praise, of pleasing people. I must die to those things. I must die to my past, of the lies that you cannot amount to anything. You can be nothing. There's nothing good that can come out of you. These things have arisen during my school time, affected my performance, affected my relationships, affected even the opportunities that God has given me, and I've kept on fighting them. Praise God for the opportunity of spiritual formation and discipleship. And then finally, I talked to a guy who went to Cambridge University and went to these different places and got amazing doctorates. And he chose, with even everybody desiring him to go and teach in these places, he chose to go to Iran to be an underground pastor. And he's one of the people that have been online, I mean, on internet and on TV. Pray for this guy because they're going to kill him. He came and I was like, I don't get it. Like, you have every qualification to get any job anywhere. But yet you choose to go to the place that nobody's going to know you, to a place that you cannot send an email, cannot be on Facebook, cannot have a phone. How would you define success? And this is how he defined it. Success is living to your maximum potential, to the pleasure and glory of God. All the talents God has given you, brought together and used to the pleasure of God, to his glory. I'll keep his name and I will not say his name. Success is living to your maximum potential, to the pleasure and glory of God. All the talents God has given you, brought together and used to the pleasure of God and his glory. For me to know who I am, for me to know who God has created me to be, for me to know my talents, I need to be able to die from the past. The voices from the past are so loud, I cannot explain. The situations, the circumstances that surrounded me. When I was 4, a traumatic event happened in my life that I stopped to grow. Like, that part of my mind just shut down. And as I continued to live through life, many other traumatic events happened that my brain shut down. I was telling my host family how I was doing an event sometime and I was traveling and I was involved in an accident. When I came back to Moody, I forgot about the accident. How do you do that? And my friends were like, what? When something happens extreme, my mind shuts down. It locks it out. Praise God that I love asking and I love talking to people. So I said, I need help. So I got a counselor. And this counselor began to walk me through my past. Some of the things began to come up. And as we speak for compassion every weekend, or often, as we tell our stories, we do not know that some things have been locked up in the drawer. We've never processed them. And as we speak, more pain comes up. And our life begins to sway. And I think there's importance of a counselor as we speak, because these things come up. And so I began to see this lady, and this lady began to walk me through. And today, Selena, our manager and our friend and our mama, told me recently, she said, Lois, it's interesting to see now how you speak up and not hurt anybody. Now you're learning how to speak up. You're finding your voice. When we begin to die, when we begin to deal with those situations, then I begin to find me. I begin to find that beautiful queen, the daughter of the king, the princess daughter that God has created me to be. And that's why Moody is important. That's why the theological experience we went through is important, because it begins to define us. It begins to define who God is, identity in God. Every dream that I ever dreamt of, praise God, thank you, compassion. I don't know, 101, I don't know, a million times infinity. Thank you so much. Because then, all the dreams that I ever had, I achieved. I was dreaming about meeting Michael W. Smith, singing before 10,000 people, speaking before, all that happened. And then I was like, okay, God, what next? And I think one of the things that God wanted to deal with me was, get those out of the way, they're nothing. And one of the things that I looked up to, because I sing, and I always wanted to sing when I was little, and I'm like, if somebody just came alongside me when I was little growing up and they helped me sing, maybe now I'd be a great singer. And so I come out here, and my desire is to go back and find these people with talents and giftings back in Uganda, in the world, find these people and come alongside them to live who God created them to be, to their full potential. Because that's what I desired, and that's what I want to give. So I began to find myself, and God began to give me sleepless nights and stir my heart towards justice and towards children and towards poverty and towards looking at this donations and gifts that are given to the third world countries and just see, are you causing dependability? Are you causing sustainability? Like, you're giving these gifts, are you developing? Praise God. I Love Compassion is my favorite organization. Not only are you giving us the funds that we need that. But we need to make a Lois, we need to make an Abel. Sustainable, that tomorrow I don't have to live without, I can live without the check of compassion. I can get a job and I can make a difference in my world. That is true success. That is true success when you make a people that don't have to turn around and open their hands to you and say, hey. In December, I went for a conference, Urbana Mission Conference, and when I was there, they brought up an event, and they made gloves and asked that these gloves will be taken to Swaziland. And the video says, and after a week, these gloves get finished, and then we wait for more. And I was like, what? So the Lois, who she is and the voice that she found, she's like, we need to talk about this. And so I woke up to the leadership of Urbana and I'm saying, great project, great that everybody was excited they're going to change Africa. But I think we need to change Africa differently. If you want to change Africa, have the factory of gloves there. Employ the Africans, teach them the use of gloves, because after a week, the video says, I go back to my polythene bag. So what difference have you made? And by the way, those people don't have food and you've given them free gloves, they'll sell them and have some food. Unless you teach them the importance of the gloves. And so it was interesting after that meeting, and by meeting came back after that, when I came back to Chicago, and great things happened. Recently, I met the First Lady of Uganda, and we're able to talk about education for Uganda and partnership between here and Uganda with education. I found my voice. Why? Because you have sleepless nights. Why? Because you take time to believe in us. I was recently watching a movie again. I watch a lot of movies. And in one of these movies, there was a guy in that movie that really loved a girl who was adopted. And I started to cry. And this girl turns around and tells the dad, thank you for accepting me. Thank you for accepting me. I have a friend here who has been a dad to me since 2006, and that's David. And I look at him every time. There's something different about his eyes. I see hope. He believes in me. I was talking to West Tuffle the other time when we were in the leadership summit, and because everybody comes and says, what are you doing after Moody? What are you doing after Moody? Oh, okay. Yeah, oh, okay. Great. Everybody wants to know, what am I going to say? You know, and West Tuffle looked at me and said, Lois, I don't mind whether you do nothing. I love you. And that was like a break into this expectation. Psh, okay, now I can fly and be who God has created me to be. And now today I can stand before you and say, I'm free to be who God has created me to be. A woman who is ready to stand for my country and have meetings and discuss about education systems and talk about these donations that come to our country and see, thank you very much, how is that crippling or creating sustainability or empowering us to exist without the support. The support is needed, but it should be towards freeing us from dependability. Thank you so much, Compassion. You have made me who I am today, and I look forward to going back to Uganda. I look forward to going back to my country and being an example not only for the country, but for leadership development students. Because Compassion has delivered us from poverty, but there's baggage that has never been dealt with. And that baggage needs a lot of counseling, needs a lot. We need to heal from that so that we can fly freely. And thank you so much. Even with the 2020 vision coming up, I think it's important for us to know the value of what we're doing. We're making complete students. We're making complete people, not just children, but adults who are going to stand up today and make a difference in the world. But the process does not end with LDP. The process does not end with a scholarship. It's a lifelong process. Like salvation is a lifelong process. We die every day. Those leadership development students have to die every day. And so it's a work that we sign up to do, but it's a lifelong work. And I pray that you will die to yourselves again and again and again, and be patient with us and give us grace when we need it, because there's a lot of baggage that maybe we've never shared with you that clogs our mind, and lies that shout and creep up. You thought the light died or the monster died, and all of a sudden it shows up and you're like, oh, you're still around. So thank you so much for standing alongside us for all these years, and may God bless you abundantly. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Lois, whom I call Dada in her language, sister. And she has taught me so many words. Wonderful. And it's such a great privilege and wonderful privilege for us to be here today. And as we are all together celebrating God's faithfulness in our lives. And I would like to thank God for all that he has done in our lives, and to give me the privilege to be at Moriah with Lois and getting to know each one of the students and to build relationship. I want to thank God for all that he has done in our lives from childhood up to now, and to what he is about to do in our lives in the future. And I want to thank my mother and father, Haitian mother and father, who are not here today, and how God has used them to raise me and to support me in every way. And also, my CDSP sponsors, Ed and Bobby Roker, that they have supported me so much. And I'm so grateful that God has put them in my life so that I can be who I am today by God's grace. And also Kevin and Helen Hennigan, who were my sponsors in LDP program. And God has used them to touch my heart so much. And also, there is a friend with all of us. He used to go to Haiti a lot, Papa Wes. And I want to thank him and all the family of Compassion International. And when Papa Wes gives you a hug, it's so warm that you can even go in the Chicago winter with him. And how to say thank you, Selena Baldwin. And one of the things that is really dear to us is the fact that Selena is not only a program manager, but also a friend. And sometimes I say, Selena, you know, we finished with all this about the program. Now, as a friend, what would you advise me? What would you tell me? And I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart, Selena and Mark Toppin. We didn't have a lot of time together, but I want to thank you and all the team. Thank you very much. And also there is Rich Von Pelt all the time coming to Chicago and back and forth. And I wonder, are you never tired, Rich? But he's coming and he's always there for us, and Elo is supporting us. And I really want to thank him. And how much more when I was in Haiti living in Port-au-Prince, and when I come here in Colorado Springs, and you know what? God has provided a house. And how to thank Kat and Jim Hilger, our host family, mom and dad. Thank you very much. Thank you. And she, mom Kat will say, mi casa, su casa. Thank you very much. And how much more about the all the LDP graduates, all who were together, the first batch, Tony, Richmond, and Michelle, and all the other fellows who were together and growing together, their support. That was so amazing. And even sometimes you need, the first batch had issue with static electricity, and even that kept on going, and even that, and they were here, there to support and to help me. Thank you very much. And how about all the students and the professors at Moriah Bible Institute, and such a wonderful family who were there to support us when we needed help, and to enter the culture when we didn't understand everything. When I put everything put in the fridge, and my roommate will come, no, this goes there, and this goes to the fridge, and all this. Thank you very much in all that you have done. So, May 18th, we were all together in line, walking. And then while we were getting into the auditorium, and then I started to see people saying, Abel, and Lois, and then, yeah, there's David, and there's Carrie, and there's Ed and Bobby, my sponsors, and they're all there and supporting us and saying congratulations, and even after, congratulations and congratulations. And then that tells me, yes, congratulations. And that says that you have success. You are successful. And you have put a goal and you achieved it. You're successful. And that brings me to think about how many people define success. And many, as Lois was sharing, saying that success is a level of social status that some people will say, or the achievement of a goal. Yeah, that's really wonderful. And you set a goal and you reach it and you're successful. And also the attainment of wealth, position, honors, or the like. Those are really wonderful definitions. And some people will go straight away to say it's the opposite of failure. And then here at Compassion, we're talking about child sponsorship and to raise kids and to shape the heart according to God's plan for their life. How do we define success? What do we see when we say success? Or when we look at a graduate of Compassion, what do we think of when we talk about success? And there are many ways or many things that we could say about all this. But we'll try to say only three things about what we think about success and how we will define success. First of all, one of the things that I will say is that success is to value what God values. It's to value what God values. You can imagine in some situation when I was a kid and then growing up in poverty, being born in a situation where we didn't have food and we didn't have drinking water and all this. And sometimes you are thinking, am I valued? Do I have value? And I remember one day I went to carry some, to take some water to bring home, and it was near a kind of canal passing by, and I was taking it, and deep in my, inside of my heart, I know it wasn't good, but I didn't have the choice, and I was wondering, I cannot even find drinking water to drink. Do I have value? Is there any value in me? But God used compassion, and someone came into my life, and my sponsors came into my life, and they started to write to me and to say, Abel, I love you. Abel, I'm proud of you. And that made me think that I have value, and someone is thinking about me, and someone cares for me. And my sponsor will say, Abel, Haiti needs people like you. How come Haiti will need people like me? Is there any value in me? But when I see about what compassion is doing to give value to kids, to people, God values people, and compassion is what we are doing to value people. And I didn't think that I had value until God used compassion in my life to tell me that you have value. And then, because of that, I know that I'm valued and I'm loved and I've been prayed for. And then I start to think that, yes, I am someone. And God wants me to know that I am someone because I was created in His image. And He used people to tell me that I love you. So we need to know that success is to value that, what God values. And I can see that you are successful because you valued me, you valued Lois, and you valued all of us and all the children that you are supporting and serving. We know that we are valued. You valued us. God values us, and you know that, and you do that. And this is something that we love about what God does through Compassion International. And then not only success is to value what God values, but also success is to achieve goals that have internal significance. There are many things that we can achieve. To have a master degree at Mori Bible Institute, or to travel for Compassion and to be speaking in front of many people. And those are things that we can see, and we can say, oh, this is really great. Or to say that we had a college education, or we can have a good job to do something. These are really good things. But we need, when we know and we go beyond all this, to see all this is not something as an end in itself, but it's a way to know that we are working in the kingdom of God, and then we are doing something today that has value into eternity. So when we do this, we know that. And in when I was in the LDP program, and then one of the things that they put a lot of emphasis on is Christ-likeness. We need to become like Christ. And when we are like Christ, while we are serving, we don't see ourselves. While we are serving, it doesn't matter that we are doing this or that, but we look at it when we're serving into a perspective into eternity. When we say that achieve goals that have eternal significance, it's not only to say that we look into eternity and we are not here and today, but when we are serving the kids today and we are teaching them about God's word, and when I was taught into the program to grow spiritually and to learn to live into integrity so that my country that is facing a lot of corruption today, they can count on someone as a Christian leader to make impact in that community. And this is something that will show people God's love, the power of God to transform lives so that they can see this is God at work. And then that will bring them to know God more. And this is what God has done in my life through Compassion International, to tell me that even if you see around you, there's a lot of corruption, but you are different because God wants you to be different, and you need to make an impact in your community to change it. And you are working with God in His kingdom. As we pray, may your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Even if we are doing something here today, this is something that has eternal value because we're working into God's kingdom. So we say that success is to value what God values, and also is to achieve goals that have eternal significance. But also, success is to give credit to whom it is due. So we can say that, wow, I have a master's degree in spiritual formation and discipleship. Whoa. You can say, now I'm a graduate of LDP. Yes, but to whom does the credit is due? And Paul the Apostle said several times to several churches, and even in 1 Thessalonians, he said to the Thessalonians, 1 Thessalonians, let me take my time, 1 Thessalonians 2, verse 19 and 20. Does that sound good? For what is our hope, our joy, or the crown in which we will glory in the presence of our Lord Jesus when He comes? Is it not you? Indeed, you are our glory and joy. So when we graduate from Moody, when we graduate from Compassion, this is not something about us. It is something about what God has done through you. So the credit is due to what God has done through Compassion International, through the sponsors, through all of you here working day and night and planning and see how many kids will have a sponsor today. And one day God used that to change my life, and I didn't have a voice myself to speak for myself, but you were the one to speak for me. So if I am who I am today, if Lois and I, we are who we are today, it's not about us. This is something that is bigger than us. This is something that God has done through you and in you. The credit is due to you. And ultimately, it is due to God. Because all that we do, we value people. God values that. And we achieve goals that have eternal significance. All this we give glory to God, to whom all glory belongs. And now that you have done all this, I can say, Compassion, you are successful. Compassion, you valued what God values. You are successful. Compassion, you achieve goals that have eternal significance. You are successful. And you give glory to God and sing all glory to God. And Papa was, when we were saying thank you, and it does like this and bring it to God. This is how all of us we are. And now, because God has used you to be successful in our lives, what will be the next step? And what will we be doing? And since December, I finished at Moody, and I went back in January. And in March 16th, I got married with my wonderful wife, and who is a former LDP, who is an LDP graduate as well, which I would like to stand. Chérie, au cas font-il camper pour assembler à Caro encore. And then I was involved in children ministry, and that's what I'm doing now and want to be more involved in children ministry. And also there is something that God has put on my heart to do ministry not only to the kids in my neighborhood, not only to the kids in my church, but also to street kids. Because I remember one day I was watching a TV show, and there was a journalist who was doing an interview with some kids, and he asked them, is there someone who cares for you? And one of them said, no one cares. And that broke my heart. And I said, God, do you want to use me as your hand to touch these kids? Do you want to use me as your heart to love these kids? And that's one of the things that we are planning to put the basis so that we can do ministry with street kids and those who are in detention center. And also, we want to do discipleship for transformational leaders, and to teach and to have classes and to have group of people that will teach for a period of time so that we can have a better Haiti tomorrow to disciple those young leaders. And also God has put on my heart to do community development in where I was born. Actually, that's where my church is still, even if I don't live there anymore, my church is still there. And one day I was passing by, and then I was greeting some people in the neighborhood, and then there is one of them who called me and said, Abel, come. And he said, honey, this is that Abel I always tell the kids to look at as a model. And that humbled me so much. And I said, praise God that he has used me to be a model for many other kids. So I want to be present in that neighborhood so that I can work with them. And since I went back, I've been meeting with some young men in the neighborhood every Sunday after church, and then share with them about what we can do together for ourselves, for the community, and for the country. And all this God has put on my heart. So, because God has used you to value me, to value us, and then I want to go back and value people. Because God has used you to reach goals that have eternal significance, I want to go back and to duplicate and to model what you have done to me into my community. And because God has used you to know that all credit belongs to him, I want to go and to do as well and to tell people all that I am is by God's grace. And he has used so many people to do that in my life, and I want to share with them. And compassion, you are successful. Compassion, you have done so great things by God's grace. Does that sound familiar to you? Releasing children from poverty in Jesus' name. We are examples of what God has done through you. You are successful. May God bless you. Thank you.
As we close, I'd like to ask Lois to come up and let us just first of all say thank you for blessing us today. Thank you for encouraging us. You guys really give us spirit and heart. And we'd like to close our time today by praying for you and asking God to really watch your next chapter. So would you stand with us as we close in prayer, and let's all reach out and really commit these amazing people back to the Lord. Father, thank you. Thank you for Abel. Thank you for Lois. Thank you for their time this morning. But most importantly, that they had a life today that has been given to you and has glorified you. Father, their chapter has been closed. New chapters are starting. And we pray that your hand and your blessing go before them, that you would make so clear their paths that they would be able to say, wow, look where God is leading me. Father, thank you for the way that their lives have changed. Thank you for the strength that they demonstrate, the amazing presence of your Holy Spirit in their lives. I pray, Lord, that as Lois encouraged us, as we die to ourselves, that your Holy Spirit would just come and empower them and give them a mighty, mighty testimony. Let the light shine through them, Lord, to everyone around them, and let you be glorified. We pray that you would bless their next chapters, that you would make them leaders, men and women who have influence in their countries for your sake. Let there be millions of Abels and Loises who are being brought up around the world. Thank you, Lord, for the testimony of these people, these amazing, amazing testimonies for you. We give them to you. We pray that you would glorify yourself. And we love you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.